Hey there, friends! Welcome back to our fun learning adventure. Today, we're diving deeper into a handy math tool, the part-whole Cheery model. If you're wondering what wholes and parts are, don't worry. Check out our previous video to get caught up. The link is in the description below. Now, let's get started. By the end of this video, students will be able to analyze a part-whole Cheery model to explain how a whole is composed of different parts and apply their understanding to create diagrams representing a given set of objects. So, what is a part-whole Cheery model? Picture a group of objects, like cherries. The whole is the entire group, and it's represented by a big circle at the top. Below it, we have smaller circles called the parts. Each part represents a smaller portion of the whole. The parts might look different and be different sizes or shapes, but together they make up the whole. So, why use this diagram? Because it visually shows how things are split or combined. It's super helpful in math and problem solving. Ready to see it in action? Let's look at some examples. Imagine you have 10 apples in a basket. You decide to split them into two groups, red apples and green apples. Here we have 6 red apples and 4 green apples. Using the part-whole Cheery diagram, we place the whole group, 10 apples, at the top. Then we draw two parts, one labeled 6 for the red apples and the other labeled 4 for the green apples. This shows how the parts, red and green apples, combine to make the whole group of apples. And it works the other way too. If you know the parts, you can find the whole. Just like apples can be split into different colors, other items can be divided in various ways too. Let's look at another scenario. Imagine you have 12 building blocks. Some are cubes and others are cylinders. Here, the whole group is 12 blocks. The parts are 7 cubes and 5 cylinders. See how the parts might look different in shape but together form the whole? Blocks come in all shapes and sizes, just like fruits in a basket. Suppose you have 15 fruits in a basket, 9 apples and 6 bananas. Now it's your turn. Can you figure out how to place the apples and bananas into the part-whole Cheery model? Think carefully. What are the parts, and how do they combine to make the whole? Did you figure it out? Let's check your answer together. The whole is 15 fruits, and the parts are 9 apples and 6 bananas. Even though apples and bananas look different, they come together perfectly to complete the basket of fruit. Great work. Let's think about a box of toys. Say the whole box has 13 toys. You separate them into two groups, 8 action figures and 5 stuffed animals. Here's a challenge for you. Pause the video and figure out how to place the action figures and stuffed animals into the part-whole Cheery model. What happens when you put the two parts together? Got it? Let's check your answer together. Using our Cheery diagram, the whole is 13 toys and the parts are 8 and 5. The parts might look different, action figures and stuffed animals, but when you put them together, they always form the whole. Pretty cool, right? Let's keep practicing. Now, let's switch gears to something delicious. Pizza. Imagine a pizza cut into 8 slices. You and your friend decide to share it. You eat 5 slices, and your friend eats 3 slices. Yum, right? How can we use the part-part-whole Cheery diagram to show how you and your friend shared the pizza? Take a moment to figure it out. Did you figure it out? Let's check it together. The whole is the total number of slices, 8. One part is your 5 slices, and the other part is your friend's 3 slices. Together, these parts make up the whole pizza. Yum! Let's move from pizzas to time management. Time to achieve some goals. Imagine you have 3 hours after school. How do you spend it? Let's say you spend 2 hours on homework and 1 hour playing. Here's a question. How can we use the part-whole Cheery diagram to show how you divide your time? Go ahead and pause the video to figure it out. Ready to check your answer? Let's see how you did. The whole is your total time, 3 hours. The parts are 2 hours for homework and 1 hour for playing. Easy, right? Using a Cheery diagram like this can help you visualize how your time is divided. It's a great tool to see how you balance activities and make the most of your day. Why not try this the next time you're planning your day? It's a fun way to make sure everything fits. And you still have time for fun. Let's try something a little different now. Let's flip the idea. Instead of starting with the whole, what if you have two parts and need to figure out the whole? Here's the scenario. You have 8 toy cars in one group and 4 toy trucks in another. How can we use the part-part-whole Cheery diagram to figure out the total? Got it? Let's solve it together. The parts are 8 and 4. When we combine them, we get 8 plus 4 equals 12. So the whole is 12 toys. Let's put your understanding of the part-whole Cheery diagram to the test. Rihanna wants to make a necklace using 12 colorful pearl beads. She plans to use 2 different colors, pink and blue. How many ways can she split the 12 beads among these 2 colors? Your challenge, 1. List all possible combinations of pink and blue beads that add up to 12. 2. Draw a Cheery diagram for each combination, labeling the whole and its parts. Remember, the parts might look different in number, but together they always add up to the whole. Have fun exploring the possibilities. Don't forget to share your answers in the comments below. As you can see, the part-part-whole Cheery diagram helps us visualize that a whole can be composed of different parts. The parts might look different and be different sizes or shapes, but they form the whole group together. This Cheery diagram is important because it allows us to break down complex problems into manageable parts. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on more fun learning videos. See you next time.